Okay, so what's number one under truth about money? What? Leverage debt, right? Number two about the truth about money. Money never sleeps.
Come on now.
But you do. So you need to find a system that allows you to make money 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. See, many of you right now, you kind of like have a time frame on how much money you can make. Like, you work 8 hours, you get paid for the 8 hours. You work a full day, get paid for a full day, or whatever. But when you're off not working, money is still doing its thing.
Yes.
Money never sleeps. Think about that. It never sleeps. Wow. Money never, ever sleeps. So wouldn't it be just ideal to be in the position that since money wants to stay awake, you might as well let it continue to circulate towards you?
Come on now.
Huh? Yeah. It's wide awake. So I might as well be wide open to get it. Right?
Right.
Listen, the name of the game when you understand that money never sleeps is that it's about passive residual income. Passive residual income. Passive residual income. That's the name of the game. And you combine the idea that money never sleeps with passive residual income, and you start to tap into what all of us people that make a ton of money already understand. We want hands-free systems that work 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. For example, how many of you remember the blackout a few years ago on the East Coast, during the blackout? Well, during the blackout, we're living in Michigan. We don't have power for like 24 hours, so we're like playing Uno cards or whatever it was, or Monopoly or something. And looking at this, I had never seen the stars, you know, before that particular. I never took the time to like look up at the sky, but I didn't really have nothing else to do, right? Couldn't play video games, couldn't do anything. So I'm looking up like, man, the sky, and I'm thinking I'm seeing like UFOs and stuff, you know, so. I had like this wild imagination. It's like, I'm seeing stuff move, and it's like, no, it made a turn. I'm talking to my wife. I said, no, it turned. You know? So there we are. But all along, while I'm sitting here in this imaginary world of seeing UFOs, when our power came back on, I looked and checked a couple of sites. I think it was like two sites that I had checked up to that point had made over $5,000 while we were sitting in the dark. Listen, money never sleeps. Money never sleeps. I remember one day we were traveling overseas. I went back and looked into our account, and just one of my products had did over $11,000 during the time that we were flying.
Get back on that plane.
Man, you're like, well, how come you didn't keep flying, right? It's like, take another trip. Just keep flying around the world until the number changes. Money never sleeps. You just have to have the right systems in place. That's it, and you're going to learn about different kinds of systems while you're here that you can get and that you can put into place. But you gotta remember that money never sleeps. When you stop working, you stop getting paid, the wealthy people and the intelligent people are not working but still getting paid. When we decide to take a time off or take a break, still getting paid.
Come on now.
Because what we did is we got into alignment with the consciousness of money, if you wanna call it that. Money is not asleep, it's always awake, so let me see what I can do to have that money to come towards me. While it's still awake, it's going to go to somebody. Why not you?
Yes.
It's like one of the things Donnie Deutsch wrote in his book. Why not me?
Come on.
Why not you? And the moment he asked himself that question, he went from a moderately successful advertising agency to one that's worth over $2.3 billion, with a B. When he asked the question, why not me? Why not you? You're here. Why not you? People come in these kind of rooms all the time. They sit there where you're sitting, and they make a decision to completely change your life, and they start to experience the same thing that you can experience. So why not you? So what is it? What's the second one in the truth about money?
Money never sleeps.
Money never sleeps. Money never sleeps. Now, taking action. We know nothing happens until you take action. One thing that I know about wealthy people is that we constantly move to take advantage of other people's wisdom.
Come on now.
For those of you that have been here, that have been to our house, you've seen the library that I have.
Yes, sir.
I am a student of every single person I can find. I mean, I have my average Amazon bill is like $2,000 a month. And to be fair, maybe a couple hundred bucks has to do with movies, but the rest of it is books, right? I love watching movies, Blu-ray discs, love it.
Come on now.
But the majority of it is books and stuff, just continuing to feed me. And I don't go buy one book. And that's a product of Amazon's system. They kind of like trap you, don't they? It's like, ooh, that looks good. I go and want to get one book, and I average like five at a time, right? And I have the boxes stacked up, and I have my schedule on when I start to plow through all of my new material and people's courses. Now, granted, I mean, I'm pretty privileged to have people send me their stuff, but I'll buy their stuff. I'm like, you don't have to refund me. If they find out that I bought it, they'll refund us. But I'll spend $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 on courses like that. They had three new courses arrive last week. Well, one of them arrived this week. Why? I'm a student.
That's good.
I'm a student. The people that make the most money have the biggest libraries.
Come on now.
They do.
That's a clue.
The people that want to make money but are not making the money have the smallest libraries. Or they have too many books that look brand new, if you know what I mean. Like you go in their house, it's like, oh man, I read this book. This is great. Did you just get it? It's like, no, I had it for a year. But it looks like it was just fresh off the bookstore. Bookstore shelf, right? And you open it up, you hear that little click. Right? I mean, at least you can fake like you're reading. Go in and dog ear some stuff and flip through it, you know, and just highlight some stuff that doesn't make sense. And somebody's like, man, you know, maybe make you feel good. Like people walk into my closet and they're like looking around. I'm like, it just feels good standing in there, doesn't it?
Right.
You just look at all this stuff and like, wow, you just walk out of it. You just feel like you're like, like an intellectual genius or something. Just being around that much information, and it's the truth. I literally plow through information because things are changing so much. The one thing that I learned a long time ago that wealthy people know is that you have to have the right information, you have to have it right now, and you have to do something with it, period. And if there's one market that's more sensitive to that than any market, it's people that trade futures and commodities, stocks, and